Getting backlinks on resource pages is one of the more beginner-level link-building strategies. But just because it's easier, it doesn't mean that it's not effective. Now the question is, how many resource pages are really out there? And if there are as many as I'm subtly implying, how can you scale this technique to really make an impact on your link profile? You're about to learn a simple system to find these link opportunities by the masses. Stay tuned. What's up SEOs? Samo here with Ahrefs, the SEO tool that helps you grow your search traffic, research your competitors, and dominate your niche. Now today is all about resource page link building, and from the people that I've spoken to, you either love it or you hate it. Well today, my goal is to make all of you believers in this low-hanging link building strategy, and more importantly, I want you to be able to start building high-quality backlinks right away. Let's get started. So first, what is resource page link building, and why is it so effective? A typical resource page usually lists a bunch of links to helpful resources on a particular topic. And the reason why it's effective is because, unlike a lot of other link building strategies, the intention behind these pages is literally to link to other resources. So by reaching out to these pages with solid recommendations, you're contributing to the purpose of that page. Whereas if you're trying to get an editorial link from a blog post, you need to do a little more convincing since their goal is to deliver their own information rather than link to external resources. Now, this link building technique is only a two-step process. First, you need to find resource type pages. And second, you need to send an email to the person in charge of that page with one or more recommendations from your site. And for the purpose of this video, we'll be focusing on the prospecting part, but I won't leave you high and dry. We have a full video on email outreach that'll help you make your email campaigns more effective. All right, so there are a few ways to find link prospects. The first is the most common, and that's to use search operators within Google. So I might type in URL colon links.html in title colon fitness. And you'll see that the majority of the results seem promising. You can also try other search queries like these. Now the great thing about these queries is that you can change any of the words in the highlighted colors to get completely new results. For example, change the links.html to links.php or resources.html or whatever footprints you can think of. After you've done enough variations of your query, you can expand your prospects by changing the topic. So instead of fitness, we might use something like workout or weight training or dieting or whatever it may be. And I'm sure you can imagine how large our list of prospects can get, right? Next, we need to scrape the URLs from these results pages and put them in a spreadsheet. And if you haven't already done so, you should change the maximum number of results per page by going to settings, search settings, and then drag the top bar to the end. Now to scrape these results, there are a couple tools you can use. The first is Scraper for Chrome. After you've installed the plugin, just right-click anywhere in the browser and click on Scrape Similar. Next, paste this string of XPath code here and click Scrape. And I'll leave that in the description below so you can copy and paste it. Finally, we'll copy it to our clipboard and paste it into a spreadsheet. Now if you're an Ahrefs user, you can just use the SEO toolbar and click on this button up here to export the results pages that you're on. Now rinse and repeat this method until you have a list of prospects that you're satisfied with. All right, so you should have a ton of link prospects by now. Don't worry if you haven't vetted these pages because we're gonna do that right now and actually filter out a whole bunch of pages without ever having to visit them. And the tool we're gonna use to do that is Screaming Frog Spider. If you haven't already exported your list of link prospects, do that first and then open up Screaming Frog. And you'll wanna make sure that you're using list mode. One quick side note for those of you who have a paid license with Screaming Frog, and Ahrefs. You can connect Ahrefs API by going to Configuration, hover over API Access, and add your API credentials when prompted. This will add various SEO metrics from Ahrefs to your crawl data, which will be super helpful later. And if you don't, you can use the batch analysis tool and connect the data with the VLOOKUP formula. All right, so just upload your file here, confirm your list of links, and Screaming Frog will start crawling those pages. Once your crawl is complete, export the results. Now let's open up our spreadsheet and we're gonna get into vetting these pages. As you can see, there's a ton of data in here and we don't need all of it for the purpose of resource page link building. So I've actually cleaned up this list to just address, status code, indexability, title, word count, unique external links, and I've left some Ahrefs metrics in here too. Now we need to filter through this data. So I'll create filters for each column. The first filter that I'll set is for pages that have a 200 response code. And we're doing this so we don't include redirected or broken pages in our resource page outreach. Next, I'll set the indexability column to only pages that are indexable. And this is to weed out pages that have been canonicalized to another URL. Next, I'll set the unique external outlinks filter to those that link to at least three unique pages. and you can get more loose or strict with these. That's up to you. But it's important that you set this, because if they have zero external outlinks, then it means that their resource page is only linking to other internal pages. So your chance of getting a link there is slim to none. Finally, I'm going to set a filter on the address column to exclude URLs that contain the word Blogspot, since I won't be interested in contacting those pages. And I know they do show up frequently for resource page search queries. And you could add additional footprints, but let's leave it at this for now. You can also set filters using Ahrefs SEO metrics. For example, if you only want to focus your attention on websites that have a certain domain rating, you can set a filter here to pages with a domain rating of, let's say, 30 or higher. After you're done setting all of your filters, go to openallurls.com. And in the text area, you can paste up to 250 URLs at a time. Just be aware that Screaming Frog uses your computer's resources, and opening a ton of URLs at once can get very resource heavy. From here, you would need to manually vet whether or not these sites would be a good place to get a link. And as you go through the list, you can just replace the URL with an X if you're not interested in contacting them. After you're done, just set another condition where the URL cannot equal X. And you should now have a solid list of pages. But why stop here when we can actually export the external links on these resource pages? And the reason it makes sense to do that is simple. Pages with a link from one resource page will likely have links from others too. So we can reverse engineer those domains and pages and find other relevant link prospects. So let's go back to Screaming Frog and run a new crawl with the filtered resource pages that we'll be contacting. This time I'll click on upload and choose to paste my list of clean URLs and run the crawl. After it's done crawling, click on the bulk export option and choose external links. Next, you'll want to open up the file, copy all rows from the destination column, and paste them into a tool like this, which will convert the URLs to domains and remove duplicates. Just make sure to set this checkbox to remove duplicates and then run the filter. After it's done, copy and paste all of the domains into a sheet because we're going to run a batch analysis on these domains. So I'll head on over to Ahrefs batch analysis tool, and I'll just paste in a good chunk of domains that were found on our prospects pages. Then I'm going to change the target mode to domain, and I can now get the SEO metrics for all of these domains at once. Now, when I'm looking through this list, I'm looking for relevant websites that have a lot of unique referring domains. So I'll sort this table by dofollow referring domains in descending order. And right away, you can tell that some of the domains are irrelevant, like Facebook and Twitter. But generally speaking, you can look at a domain name and get a good idea of the type of content they would produce. So this one from acefitness.com seems promising. So I'll click on the caret beside the domain and click on backlinks, which will open up their backlink profile in Site Explorer. Next, I'll search for one of our footprints like links.html using the include filter. And just like that, you have a lot more resource pages that you can start pitching for links. Also, you won't need to run another crawl with Screaming Frog on these pages, since the EXT column shows you the number of external outlinks on that page. So you can quickly identify whether you have a good chance of gaining a link or not. From here, all you need to do is reach out to these sites, pitch your resources, and hope to get a bunch of new quality links back to your site. So as you can see, there is no shortage of resource pages where you can get backlinks. You just have to follow the rabbit hole, and you can literally find and qualify thousands of link prospects in under an hour. Now, if you enjoyed this video, make sure to like, share, and subscribe. And if you have any questions, then leave a comment and I'd be happy to jump in. So keep grinding away, and I'll see you in the next SEO tutorial.